lesson with me, but today I'm going to teach you some of the most used expressions, love expressions that I use in particular with my daughter, but you can also use with your loved ones. These are very, very unique expressions, mainly in the Palestinian dialect or usually in spoken Arabic, not in standard Arabic. So these are super, super helpful and useful and very beautiful. Let's begin. Before we start with the lesson, please make sure to leave a comment below if you like it and to subscribe to the channel, turning on the notifications. Please follow me also on Instagram. I'm there. I have daily vlogs and daily content and quizzes in Arabic at Maha Yaqoub. And also make sure to like my Facebook page. We are almost 100,000 people there. Learn Arabic with Maha is the page name. One word, Learn Arabic with Maha. Without further ado, let's start with the lesson. For sure you've heard of Habibi. Habibi, if you are male, I can tell you Habibi. Literally, Habib literally means lover or beloved. Habibi is my lover, my beloved. Adding the E makes everything mine. So Habibi, if you're a male and you are my lover. And Habibti, Habibti, so instead of E, you add T. If you're a female, you're my lover and you're a female, Habibti. You have heard about this. For sure, Habibi and Habibti in songs and everything. So I'm not gonna concentrate on that. I usually don't call my daughter, for example, Habibti. I would use it, but not as much as the next expressions. One of the funny things that we Arabs use in order to express love is to call our beloved person parts or dear parts of our body. For example, ayuni or aini. It means my eye or my eyes. This is a very, very used common expression to call your loved one, to call them my eye, my eyes. And this is the one that I use the most, actually, with my daughter. When she tells me mama or yamma, I tell her ayuni. Ayuni, yes, my eyes. Now, let's build it together. Ayn or ayn in standard Arabic, it means eye. My eye, ayni, adding the E, you know that. عيني. If I want to make it in the plural, عين, which means I, becomes the عيون. عيون. You have to practice on your a little bit. عين. عيون. My عيون, my eyes. عيوني. Very easy. So one eye, عيني, and many eyes, عيوني. My many eyes. عيوني. So عيوني, it's a beautiful, beautiful love expression that you can say. It's not an expression, it's a word that you can tell your beloved one. You can tell them, انتي, you are عيوني, you are my eyes. Or انتي, عيني, you're my eye. Huh? عيني or عيوني, it doesn't mean that you love them more if you say you're my eyes, rather than saying you're my eye. That doesn't matter. Both are the same level of love, and it's a very deep and pure and a big love when you call somebody on where you answer somebody, عيني or عيوني. And a beautiful thing about all these expressions is, if you want to emphasize the love, we usually exaggerate in everything we do, Arabs, and especially in the language usage. So what I usually do, and many Arabs do, is we say عيون عيوني or عين عيني. So you just double the word or the expression to show even more love. So this morning, Layla, before when we woke, she woke up, she told me she was scared, probably having a nightmare, and she told me, Yumma, Yumma, she was like, and then me showing her love or to try to comfort her, I don't tell her ah or aywa or whatever, or habibti. I right away said, ayuni, ayuni, you're the eye of my eyes, the eyes of my eyes. You're not only my eyes, you're the eyes of my eyes. So you're even more important to me than the eyes of my eyes. So I told her, ayuni, ayuni, as an answer to her calling me yamma. Okay, so it's not only you can say to your loved one, you are my eyes, or you are my eye. You can also answer them when they call you by saying, yes, my eyes, yes, eyes of my eyes, yes, my eye, yes, eye of my eye. So let's repeat the expressions again. عيني, عين عيني, the eye of my eye, عين عيني, or عيوني, my eyes, and عيون عيوني, عيون عيوني, the eyes of my eyes. The next body part that we use a lot in love expressions is heart. Okay, you also for sure use it in your languages. Heart more than I. Heart in Arabic we say alb, Usually it's qalb, but in spoken Arabic and in most dialects we don't pronounce the qa, so we pronounce it just a simple glottal stop, alb. Alb means heart. Alb, my heart, albi. So in order to say my love, my lover, my dear, huh? You say albi, my heart. Layla can call me, and I would also randomly choose one of these. I use most the one that I told you before, Ayuni, but I also use albi and I use all the next ones. That's why I'm showing you them in this lesson. So albi. Ah, ya albi. Yes, my heart. Ah, ya albi. Albi. We don't say my heart, so we wouldn't use alubi, we don't use that. But what we use is the same functionality of emphasizing and doubling the same expression. For example, you're not only albi, you're alb albi. Huh? You're the heart of my heart. Huh? You're not only albi, my heart, you're the heart, alb, of my albi. Inti alb albi. Or she might call me yumma and I will tell her, ah, alb albi. Huh? Ya alb albi. Okay? Beautiful expressions, use them. You can use the single one, albi, or aini, or ayuni, and you can use the emphasized one, alb albi, aini, aini, ayuni, ayuni. And the next one is haya. Haya means life. So if you want to say my lover, my life, you say hayati. Hayati, it has a reason why it became ti and not hayai, but it doesn't matter for this lesson. It's just because the word haya is feminine, ends with this t sound. So my life would be hayati. Hayati, okay? Hayati. You are hayati. Ah, hayati. Yes, hayati. Yeah, wouldn't just simply say ah, hayati. You're saying yes, my love. Mm? Yes, darling. Yes, dear. Okay? Yes, my life. You wouldn't use it. I think you have it, like, or you can understand it, but you wouldn't use it. What I'm trying to point out is that in Arabic, we use it in a daily life, and we repeat it a lot, and it's like just simply saying, say, yes, my love, yes, darling, yes, my dear. Literally saying, my life. Huh? Hayati. And again, here applies the same rule that I told you before, hayat hayati. The life of my life. You're not only hayati inti, inti hayat hayati yumma. Inti hayat hayati. Okay, not only your hayat, hayat hayati. Another one is the word umr. Umr becomes umri. Umr means age or years in general, like all my year, my life, years, okay? Age. So imagine telling somebody, oh, hey, my age. Oh, you are my age. In Arabic, it sounds so beautiful because you're showing your love, saying you're my age. Inti umri. There's a very famous also Arabic song called Inti umri for the legend of Arabic music, Miss Kulthum. I probably have heard of her. She's really the legend of Arabic music. She's Egyptian. She has this very, very particular song called Inti umri. What is the meaning of Inti umri? You are my age. But what does this whole song mean? That this song lasts, by the way, 1 hour in Ta'amri. So she's basically not saying you are my age, but she's saying you're my love. Huh? You're the love of my life. Because in Ta'amri, you are my age. You're my years. So Umr, Umri is a very, very used expression. I also call my daughter a lot of times, ah, ya Umri. Huh? And I also make sure to emphasize it sometimes and say, Umr, Umri. You're not only my age, you're the age of my age. These might sound weird, but again, I'm repeating and repeating. These are very, very much used expressions in a daily basis. I use them. I use most, I told you, ayuni, ayuni, but I use also rohi, albi, umri a lot. Umri is very, very much used, and also used in the song of Kulthum called Inti umri. I'll send you also the link below so you can listen to the music of Inti umri and see how beautiful it is when you repeat it so much. So many times. The next one is roh. Roh or ruh, the same meaning, but we pronounce it mostly as roh. Roh means soul, okay? You're my soul, rohi. Rohi, inti rohi. And rohi is very much used in the doubling thing, in the emphasizing. Roh rohi. You're not only rohi, my soul, you're the roh of my rohi. You're the soul of my soul, huh? Roh rohi. Yes, roh, roh. I swear to God, I use them every day with my daughter. So you can use them with your beloved ones, and try to use them also the doubling. If you have a beloved Arab, person, of course, you wouldn't go to your Swedish love and tell them "roh rohi." If you're learning Arabic and you have beloved Arab member, a person, use these expressions and they will love them and they will really feel loved. And it shows, of course, that you're learning and getting more into the culture of the language you're learning. Okay, so rohi, rohi, and roh rohi. Let's repeat all these together and then I'll add one more. I taught you aini, ain aini, or ayuni, ayuni ayuni. Then I taught you albi, alb albi. Then I taught you hayati, my life, hayat hayati, life of my life. Then I taught you umri, the age. Umr umri, the age of my age. All these to say love, my love, my lover. And then I taught you rohi, roh rohi, the soul of my soul, or my soul, rohi, to say my love, my lover. The last one that I want to tell you that I also use a lot is noor ayuni. I don't know if you've heard of this. You know, of course, now the word ayuni, my eyes, or aini, my eye. Noor ayuni or noor aini, it means the light of my eyes. Noor is light. Noor aini, the light of my eye. Noor ayuni, the light of my eyes. This is a very, very popular Arabic expression, but all Arabs, by the way, doesn't depend on like where you come from. Noor ayuni is a very, very popular Arabic expression to say you're the light of my eyes, which means you are so dear to my heart. You are the love of my life. You are my love. You're my darling. You're my dearest thing ever. You are noor ayuni, the light of my ayuni. Noor ayuni. These were some of the most important and most used Arabic expressions when it comes to calling the person you love or answering them. If you have something similar in your language that you call somebody your age in order to say he's your love, or your eye in order to say he's your love, please mention them below. Tell me what language is yours and show me the sentence that you use it. If you have something similar like this, please make sure to comment below if you like this video and subscribe to my channel. Please follow me on Instagram at Maha Yaqoob, and like my Facebook page, Learn Arabic with Maha. If you like these kind of lessons, please show me the love, because I do read almost all of your messages and your comments. Don't forget also that I just opened the application for my next beginner Arabic course in the Holy Land in Nazareth this December, from the 14th until the 23rd of December. A full immersive Arabic course in the language and in the culture in the heart of the old city of Nazareth. So if you are interested and you want to know how to apply and all the information, you can find them in the link that I'm going to give you here below in the description box. And that's it for now. I hope to see you on a following Arabic lesson with me, Maha. Bye, ma'a salama.